We are in the relationship business. What's exciting is I'm with the best I know at this. We're going to talk with JD Sullivan today about how to build relationships that'll generate more business. All right, JD, this is a conversation that, I'm excited to share with people. You and I have had some of these conversations before, and I don't say this, man, we're friends. I'm not saying this to blow you up, but you're the best I've ever seen at taking an opportunity, no matter where you are, and turning it into a relationship. So let's just talk about kind of what that looks like, you know, especially in our coastal environment. Everybody's here on vacation. So let me just say this. What does an average day look like for you in this business where other people might think you're not working, but you're actually working?
Yeah, let's don't. I trick them fair and square, Jimmy. Right. I think what we have to understand in this business, this is relationship business, and we are in sales, okay? Mm-hmm. But we don't want to come across as a salesman. Mm-hmm. So we want to live our life. Look, we all chose to live here for a reason. It's a beautiful place to be. There's so many activities, there's things to do. But when you're doing those things, you're always thinking in some level and at some degree, sales. Mm-hmm. How do I create a relationship with someone that I don't know? We used to joke when I would go to the pool at Watercolor when I used to live there. In my earlier days, my wife would get the bag and the sunscreen and the toys for the kids. I would get cards, a pad, and a pen.
That's right. Yeah.
And I was determined to meet 3, 4, 5 people that day. And I wasn't going out looking around and seeing who can I go bother, mm-hmm. because no one wants someone to come bother them. But people thought that I was just going to the pool. Maybe I was going to the pool, but there was an objective there. There was an objective to meet people. So people are very relaxed when they're on vacation. So I'd meet them in the bar line or something, where are you from? And start a conversation. It was starting a conversation. And that's not evasive. Or invasive. It's not, you're not in their face. It's not like going to a used car dealership where they're just constantly on your face.
Right.
I'm just creating a conversation. The guy has no idea what my objective is. My objective is to get his information, his phone number, his email address, his social security number, whatever the hell I could get.
That's right.
But we would talk and we'd create a relationship. And then eventually I'd lead in to the question would be asked of me, what do you do?
Yeah.
Oh, I live here. Oh, so what do you do here? How do you live here? I'm in real estate. Really? We've been coming here for 15 years. Okay, that tells me one thing. All right. This is our first time here. Oh, really? Let me tell you about the area. Let me do this or that. Here's my card. If you ever need anything, let me know. Not, hey, if you want me to show you a house.
Right.
It's if you need anything. You want me to set up a fishing charter? You want me to do something for you? So it's just creating a relationship. But then you have that information. The next thing was, how do you touch them and continue to touch them?
Yeah.
And that's what I would do constantly. I'm old school. I'm working on Jimmy. But I have a pad.
Yeah.
And I would write names down. I have them all in my room. In my office. And I would go through and I'd write my notes on there about they have 3 kids. One's they're from Georgia. They're fans of the Georgia Bulldogs. And I would just send, hey, nice game by the Bulldogs. And it was just a touch point.
Right.
So every time they would come back, they would say, hey, John David, we're here. You want to have a cup of coffee? Or where can we go deep sea fishing? This, that, and the other.
Right. So I think this is important. It's one thing to get the names. But if you're just getting the name and the contact information, this is not an automated deal. You can't build relationships automated. It has to be personal. So talk to me a little bit about, because you talked about the initial follow-up. What are these, how are you keeping, you know, I know you got it in your notebook. Do you then make notes where you've talked to them or you send them the text where you keep in touch with that?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And that took me a while to be able to be good at that. But that was something that was imperative to me because the personal aspect of the touch, the retouch was important. Remembering a name, remembering a wife's name, remembering where they're from, or if their son goes to a certain school, I put that in my notes. So when I send a text or an email back to them, I would have some personal aspect that let that person know I was paying attention.
Right.
During our conversation.
Right. You know, another thing that I think you do extremely well is that it's not just that one relationship. What I've seen you do is as you deepen the existing relationship with people, they end up taking you wide with their friends. How do you branch that to where you begin to be a part of those conversations where they're thinking of you for their friends and family?
Because it becomes personal. Mm-hmm. I think it has to become personal. The more that I am not a salesman,
right,
the more they trust me.
Right.
Yeah. The more I become a friend, mm-hmm, and we don't have to be best friends,
yeah,
but I would say, I can't tell you how many of my clients, when they come in town, they call to have a cup of coffee, mm-hmm, catch up,
right,
what's going on in the market.
Right.
They're curious about what's happening here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Whether they own property, they're really curious what's right happening here. If they don't, they want to see when that opportunity exists, what's happening, is there going to be a shakeup or not. So creating a personal relationship without being a salesman, and then they start to trust, then they bring their friend, hey, I'm staying here with so-and-so and my friend's here, and then it just continues to grow. I can't tell you that I've sat in an open house in probably 5, 6, 7 years, which is one of the best things you can do as a young agent to continue to get new clients. But for me, it's all referral business at this point.
Right. Who'd have thought? I mean, you're one of the few people, I think, that people don't realize. They think that a business has to look a certain way. They have to think, they have to come in and they have to make cold calls. They think they have to do certain things. In reality, there's no one way to do the business. To me, if you're looking for balance in life, the way you've built this, who'd have thought, you know, trips to the pool, happy hours would have turned into $1 billion+ worth of sales.
That's what it needs to be. I mean, you're living the lifestyle. You're selling the lifestyle. If they don't see you living the lifestyle, then they think it's all a joke or it's not true.
Right.
So I don't show up. I mean, I used to wear a suit. I used to have 20 suits in my closet when I was in my prior life. I had to buy a suit for something not too long ago. I didn't have one.
Right.
I'm a flip-flops and shorts and a t-shirt to most times. I do have a collared shirt on today because we were videoing.
This is great.
It's really impressive.
I really appreciate you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have a bathing suit on under this, but but you don't want to show up and make them feel uncomfortable.
Yeah.
So they're coming off the beach, they're on vacation, they're having a good time. You want to be relatable.
Yeah.
So that was very important to me to continue to show them that I live this lifestyle. If I go out on a golf course and someone invites me to go play golf, people think, oh, JD's golfing, he's not working. I'll be damned if I'm not working.
Right.
I've got 4 hours in a golf cart with one person I might know and two other people that I don't.
That's right.
And that's by the end of that 4 hours, I've got 4 friends,
right?
Guaranteed.
Yeah.
So it is extremely important to not just sit in your office and make cold calls. If I go to Bud Nally's or I go to any bar, we're a sales business. We need to be social.
Right.
We need to talk to people. People want to talk to you. They want to hear your story. Craft your story the way you want it, but when I meet someone at the bar, I'm always asking, where are you from?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, have you been coming here for a while?
Yeah.
I want to know if they're new to the area or if they know the area.
Yeah.
If they say, I've been here for 15 years, I said, oh, so where do you own? Mm-hmm. Well, we don't own. I'm like, why don't you own? Have you not seen what the hell's been going on for 15 years?
Right.
Yeah. There's an opportunity for you, sir,
right,
or ma'am.
Yeah.
So it is not just sitting in your office. It is living the lifestyle.
Yeah, I would agree. And I had a old fishing guide out west one time tell me that, listen, you have to match the hatch. So if the fish are biting on a certain thing, you want to have your bait look like what they're wanting.
Yeah.
Listen, they don't want you in a suit. They don't want, you know, listen, I've always said this, especially in our environment here, the majority of the people we're selling to, especially on the luxury side, they're coming to the beach and they want their hat backwards, t-shirts, and they want to drink beer all day on the beach, just like they did in college.
They want to have the lifestyle that we are fortunate enough to live.
That's right.
They want that. And
yes,
they see someone that's living that. They want to know how you did that.
It's attraction.
Okay. And then secondly, it is, you need to be, in my opinion, the expert.
Yeah.
Now, you may not be the expert on everything,
right,
but you need to know and you need to have a script to a degree.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Or let's just say at least deal points or points that you're going to make during that conversation. And you know, sometimes you prompt the question to get the question so you can give the deal point.
Right.
But But it's also just being genuine.
Yeah.
And I'm telling you, I've met and done more deals, multi-million dollar deals, by sitting at a restaurant at Barago at the bar, and I meet someone and we start talking, and I'm getting information from them. They don't even know I'm doing it.
Right.
And then by that time, I become friends with them, and I vacation with my clients. I mean, it's just, and it's just a relationship business, and we should embrace that. This is fun. This doesn't have to be hard work. Mm-hmm. It's just getting out and being yourself and getting to meet people, and the more that they trust you, that's where the expert part comes in.
Right.
Give them the information that they need, and then let them make the decision, and then just guide them and help them.
Yeah. Let's wrap up with this. One of the things that I've seen you do so many times to drive relationships deeper is I've seen you provide tickets to wine festivals. I've seen you invite people to special events, to concerts. Talk about some of those where you're targeting, you know, opportunities to spend more time with people. Golf, I've seen you do those things. What do you think of when you're thinking of that, and are you tailoring that to what the people like, or is it just what's available?
Not necessarily tailoring to what I think they like. It's more or less just making sure that I'm staying connected to them, whether it's in a sporting event or it's a golf outing or it's a happy hour or a cup of coffee. It's knowing that when they're here, hey, I pull my sheet out, my antiquated, you know, spiral notebook, and say, oh, Jimmy's going to be here. Let me call Jimmy and say, hey, listen, let me know when you're in town. Let's get together. Let's go fishing. Let's go out on the boat. Let's go golfing. Let's go have a drink. It's never let's go look at house.
Right.
Ever.
Right. Yeah.
I mean, because that's the salesman that they don't want. They want the guy that lives at the beach going, man, I wish I could live that lifestyle. Mm-hmm. Show them that lifestyle and show them that you can help them achieve that.
Yeah, that's good stuff. Listen, if you're wondering about how you're going to grow your business, in reality, it's the person that has the most relationships and the deepest relationships are the ones that are going to do the most business. Man, appreciate you, JD.
Yeah,
we're
going to,
this has been good stuff. Listen, if you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out, and we'll talk to you soon.
Thanks for watching the video. I specifically chose the video below for you because it builds on the one you just watched. I hope it's helpful, and I'll talk to you soon.